here what I did is, I treated a language like just a set of forms. I made a new language up, what's it called? And this is when the headaches start. This is when, so I've arranged them for you, but normally, your reaction when you see something like this is you're gonna like panic and break into a sweat and start crying and wonder why you ever came into linguistics. And then you're gonna take a few deep breaths and then you're gonna remember what I told you and it's gonna all work out okay. And so always go for the easy stuff. Start with the easy stuff. If you need to rearrange the data, rearrange the data. But you just gotta find the easy stuff. So what's the easiest things to figure out here? Well, okay, we've got a suffix. Let's just say we know that. Once you do that, and you start listing your alternates, okay, where would you start? Which is the easiest? Oh yeah, dog, right. Okay, I screwed up in my... Okay, right. So dog has only one alternate. It's loosh. Okay? And this has two, loose and loosh. And this has two, it's loosh and loosh. I'm going to confuse myself. Okay? And then you start panicking, but it's really easy if you just do things, you just follow, start with NAA. So what does NAA tell you for an underlying form?
Loosh.
Loosh for dog. Okay? And once you do that, you know that you get rid of that, and you get rid of that. And then it's easy. Right? See how easy it is? Because you can't have a rule that makes should become S word finally, because that's going to screw you up here. And you can't have a rule that makes should become sh word finally, because that's going to screw you up here as well. Okay? So then once you eliminated those other possibilities, your lexicon just falls off the board for you. So that's loose. See that? So imagine I just jumbled these all up. It would have been really confusing. But it's the same old thing. And then our segment mapping diagram is kind of simple. You know how to draw it? Do you guys know what to draw for the segment mapping diagram, right? So it's just, you've got some underlying segments. You've got some surface segments. And we could draw two of them, right? So we could say there's what's emerging? Well, let's write the rules out. There's a rule that says S to sh before I. And there's another rule that says, sh before I. Okay. So for now, we have to treat these as separate rules. So let's do our first segment mapping diagram for the first set of forms. Okay, so we have sh, and we've got s, and we've got sh, and we've got s, and sometimes sh goes to sh, and sometimes s goes to s, but sometimes what else? What do I do now? S goes to sh sometimes, right? Like that. Okay? And then with this other part, I would have, sh mapping to sh, sh, sh mapping to sh, but sometimes, right? Yeah?
Do we have to put them in separate
No, that's the point, is that the next thing we can do is just compress these and just put this looks like a big complicated mess, and it's useful to put them together. But remember what I said at the beginning is, what we want to see is that even these big complicated messes are really just combinations of our small, simple system. And so I can unpack it again, and we're back to our simple segment mapping diagram of one simple neutralization, let's say it goes like this. Right? So we just have two cases of the same thing. And that they just happen to converge on one of the neutralizations. Okay, so we have two things that happen to neutralize to the same thing. But I think I made a fancy name for this in the book. I think I called it multiple convergent neutralization. Okay, so neutralization, we just talked about what it means. And multiple means it's going to be about more than two things.